Hello, welcome to Attorney Mayu's channel. Here, I talk about legal issues that foreigners in Japan may encounter. Today, I'm going to talk about regulations on importing cosmetics to Japan. When you intend to import your cosmetics into Japan, first, you must check whether your products are cosmetics under Japanese law. The definition of cosmetics is as written here. There are three key points in this definition. First,Your products have to be used on the body. They should not be taken or injected into the body. If they are taken in, then it's not cosmetics. Secondly, the products have to have mild effects, not strong effects. Third, pharmaceuticals and quasi-pharmaceuticals are not cosmetics. They're subject to more strict regulations. Then, to import your products must meet cosmetics standards. Its English version can be found here.There are negative lists and positive lists. Negative lists list up ingredients that are forbidden to be included in cosmetics. Positive lists list up ingredients that are regulated in terms of quantity or usage. Also, you must show all the ingredients on the label when selling in Japan. If you meet these conditions, then you can import your products through Japanese company or branch. So, before importing,You have to prepare a base in Japan. It can be your Japanese branch, subsidiary, or another independent distributor. It can be anything, but you have to have a company in Japan to sell your cosmetics. And such a company has to have usually two types of permits, permit for manufacturing and permit for selling. Permit for manufacturing is not only for manufacturing cosmetics, but also for packaging, labeling, and storage.To sell a cosmetic product in Japan, you should accommodate its packages and labeling to Japanese version. And you also have to have the capacity to store them in Japan. For that packaging, labeling, and storage, the Japanese company have to have manufacturing permit even though they do not manufacture the products itself. And of course, since you will sell your products in Japan, the Japanese company also has to have selling permit.Both permits require you to have at least one pharmacist as a full-time personnel and requires you to prepare various documents regarding facilities and quality control. Thus, it might be better you contract with a Japanese distributor with such permits if you want to start small. If you contact the JETRO, Japan External Trade Organization, JETRO will let you know several distributors in Japan with such permits.After obtaining such permits or contracting with a company with such permits, then the Japanese company should submit two registrations. One is for a manufacturer registration or for a manufacturer and seller registration. It must be filed with Pharmaceuticals and Medical Devices Agency called PMDA, and you must attach a list of items to be imported. This is to register an exporting foreign manufacturer.The Japanese company also must submit cosmetics manufacturing and selling registration. This is for each item, so you have to prepare one document for one item. With such permits and registrations, you can import cosmetics into Japan. After importing, when selling cosmetics in Japan, there are lots of regulations you have to comply. Here, I'll refer to major ones. First, you must have appropriate labels.The label should include name and address of the manufacturer and the seller, name of product, lot number, all the ingredients in descending order. And you also have to comply with laws on recycling. Upon using paper or plastics in your packages or containers, you must have specific labeling on packages or containers.The mark on the left is for paper and the mark on the right is for plastics. When your product is a spray type, then you should be aware of law for handling high pressure gas. Under such regulations, you must have certain warning expression on your labels. When you are selling them online, you have to clearly indicate on your website their price, when and how to pay, when to deliver, return policy,and name, address, phone number of the seller, etc. Last but not least, there are ads regulations. For example, You cannot advertise your products to have effects on wrinkles or sagging, or to have effects of removing spots or freckles. You can only use expressions specified by the government. The regulations explained before are for import for business purposes. If you engage in private import, no permit or registration is needed. Private import is the import made by consumers for the purpose of using the products themselves and not for selling. Again, when it is private import, you do not need permit or registration mentioned before. But the number of units that you can import at one time is limited to a certain extent, 24 units for normal size items and 120 units for small size items. If you want to engage in private import to sell your products directly to customers in Japan, you must indicate on your website that consumers should follow importing procedures and pay for import fees themselves. Also, you must comply with the online selling regulations as explained before, that is, clearly indicate on your website price, when and how to pay, etc. One last thing, quasi-pharmaceuticals. If your products have certain active ingredients specified by the government, then it can be approved as quasi-pharmaceuticals. Such active ingredients are shown from page 306 of this paper found on this website, though it's in Japanese. When your product is approved as quasi-pharmaceutical, you can express certain effects in your ads in more advantageous way than that of cosmetics. Today's tips are, first, upon importing cosmetics to sell them in Japan, you must have a company in Japan with manufacturing and selling permits, and you must submit two types of registrations. Secondly, be advised that you must comply with various regulations upon selling cosmetics from labeling to advertising. Thank you for watching. For more information about me and my office, visit this website. I also accept online legal counseling so that you can seek legal advice even if you are outside Tokyo or abroad. Have a great day.